Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. In this video I want to do something very interesting but also very different than my usual content. So today I was reading my YouTube comments and my Instagram comments and messages, and I decided to make a video where I will answer the most interesting questions that you asked, and then I have also a lot of developer tips to give you. So here in front of me I have a list of questions that you asked. And the first question says, why are you using Light Team Visual Studio for your tutorials? Actually, to be more honest, someone has said that real developers use Dark Team. Now, this has nothing to do with your developer skills. It's just a personal preference. And I personally prefer dark themes, except for my tutorials. And the reason is, when I first started making tutorials, I got messages from people who are watching my videos on very slow internet connection, on very small resolutions. And it is much easier for them to read dark letters on light background than vice versa. So that is the reason why I use Light Team, because I believe that making it available for more people is a stronger argument than personal preference. But if you really prefer dark themes, I guess that you can use shades. I'm just kidding, and this is because someone had asked a question related to this as well, and that is, how do you reduce the eye strain caused by using a computer screen? And this is a very good question. For this, I can recommend an application that I have been using for a long time. It's called Flux, and I will put it here. It's basically a free application for Windows and Mac and Linux, and it allows you to adjust the color of your display so that it is much easier to look at your computer screen. And then another tip is to use computer glasses, like the ones that I have on right now. They are also called blue light filter glasses. And right now I have a ring light in front of me, as you can see in my glasses, and it is pretty intense, but it is much easier to look at with the glasses on than without. And then I would say the most important tip is to take regular breaks. Every 45 minutes to an hour, make sure to go outside and look at some distant objects and try to relax your eyes. And this is something that I have been doing a lot when I lived at my parents' place, because we had a big backyard, and I would go outside and I would just look at grass and trees and water, and I would really feel my eyes relaxing. So if you live near a forest or near a river, definitely use that, because those things are the most natural things for your eyes to look at. And then also I tried certain supplements and vitamins, and then some very useful eye exercises, to be honest. But since I don't want to make this answer too long, if you are interested in more tips related to this question, make sure to put it in the comment section and I might make a full video related to this topic in the future. The next question says, are you going to do any other programming languages besides C++? As some of you already know, currently I work as C# developer most of the time, and then I work on JavaScript projects from time to time. So please let me know in the comment section if you would like me to make C# and JavaScript tutorials, because I could do these two languages very easily. Now, question number four, or actually comment number four, is that many people said that they are watching my videos to learn English. And this was a big surprise for me, because I am not a native English speaker, and the language is the biggest obstacle for me personally, because many times I forget how to say something or I mispronounce a word, so I have to repeat and refilm everything. But I am very happy if my tutorials help you to learn English as well. And then also I got a question related to the languages that I speak. And I cannot say that I speak all of these languages, but I can form a few sentences, and then I can have some basic conversation on English and Spanish and Portuguese, French and German as well. And then my native language is Bosnian, and it is Slavic language, which means that I can understand a little bit of other Slavic languages like Russian and Polish and other Slavic languages in general, but I don't speak any. So for all my viewers from English-speaking countries, please allow me a few sentences on these other languages. So what can I say in Spanish? Muchos saludos para todos mis seguidores que hablan español. Los quiero mucho y gracias por apoyarme. A mí siempre me gustaron las canciones en español, así que decidí aprender el idioma un poquito. And then Portuguese is actually very similar. Muitas saudações a todos os meus seguidores que falam português. Eu amo muito a todos vocês e obrigada pelo seu apoio. French as well is very similar to these other two. So, salutations à toutes les personnes qui parlent français. J'ai étudié français pendant 4 ans à l'école et je le parle un peu. And then German is actually very different than these other languages. And I studied German in school, but it was not successful. So I found this course on YouTube. It's called German with Michelle Thomas, and it helped me a lot. So it's definitely a recommend to anyone who is trying to learn German. What can I say in German? Viele Grüße an alle meine Freunde, die Deutsch sprechen. Ich habe vor 2 Jahren Deutsch gelernt in der Schule und ich spreche es ein bisschen. And then my native language sounds like this. Veliki pozdrav za sve koji me razumiju. Puno vas volim, pišite mi u komentarima odakle me gledate i hvala vam na podršci. And I also get a lot of comments from people watching me from other countries, especially from India, and I would love to say thank you. I never had the opportunity to learn your language, but I would love to. And the same goes for all my viewers in other countries that I didn't mention. So please feel free to write in the comments section from which country are you watching this video, because I would love to read that. Question number 5, and I'm going to quote this one. It says, why do C++ developers feel superior? First of all, I won't say that if someone is trying to make himself look better by putting you down, that is not superior, that is just insecure. And then second thing is that the best C++ developers that I met are actually very humble people, and I would never say that they think of themselves as superior. Now, with this being said, I also might have an idea why some people would say something like this, that C++ developers are superior. C++ is a low-level language, which means that someone who works in C++ language already has a very good understanding of all of the encapsulations and abstractions that high-level languages use. Whereas a developer who works in a high-level language like JavaScript, for example, that developer does not need to have the understanding of those lower-level things. They just use them. So that could be a potential reason why someone would say that C++ developers are superior. But again, I don't feel like this. I disagree with this because C++ was the first language that I learned, and if I thought that I was superior, I would never learn a higher level language like JavaScript, for example, which I did. I learned JavaScript because they are very different languages. They have different use, different purpose, and each one comes with different set of skills that you need to learn. So I hope that this answers your question. Question number 6 is tips to learn programming easier. So this is a question from a person who says that he starts learning and then he feels unmotivated very quickly. So I could make an entire video related to this topic, but since I don't want to make this answer too long, I'm going to give you one very effective but also very quick and easy tip that you can use if you cannot motivate yourself to learn. And then I would also like to ask you to leave your own tips for learning and motivation in the comment section, because those might help to someone else, and then someone else's tips could help you to learn and stay motivated. But my tip that I believe most people don't think of is, if you are trying to learn anything, not just programming, and you cannot motivate yourself to do so, please start hanging out with people who are already good at that thing. So make friends with people who already know what you are trying to learn. And this goes for every other aspect of life, not just learning programming. If you're trying to become healthy and fit, start hanging out with people who are already healthy and fit. If you're trying to become rich, start hanging out with people who are rich. So I believe that this is a very important tip, very useful tip that most people don't think of. Question number 7 says, am I too old to start to learn programming? And this person is 30 years old. Now, before I answer this question, I want to say that most people start in their late teens or in their early 20s. So by the age of 30, most of them already have some working experience. Now, on the other hand, most people in their 30s already have a full-time job, a family, some have kids or are planning to have kids. And these things take a lot of time. And on the other hand, programming also takes a lot of time. So does this mean that you are too late? The answer is no, but you have to understand that it is going to be much harder for you than for someone who is younger and does not need to think about these other things. Now, one thing that you can use to your advantage as well is if you have family, if you have kids, use that as your motivation, because then you definitely want to get a better job, a better salary. You want to provide a better life for your family and for your kids, not only for yourself. So my answer is no, it's never too late. You are going to have self-doubt. That is normal. That is human nature thing. And the only way to overcome that is to work and don't give up. And one very important thing is don't listen to people who are telling you that you cannot do it. And I am saying this from my personal experience, because when I started my YouTube channel, that was almost a year ago, a person who was very close to me told me that I should not do it, that I will never reach more than 1,000 subscribers because I come from a very small country and I will just never be able to reach people outside of my country. And then also there are other channels who already have millions of subscribers, so why should I even try? And I just ignored it. I didn't listen and I worked. And even if only one person is watching my videos, that is one person that I'm helping, and that counts. So that is the advice that I can give you. So a year ago, I didn't know anything about being a YouTuber. I have a full-time developer job. I don't have kids, but I do have family and friends. English is not my native language, and I have a killer training almost every single day. So that leaves me with very little time that I can dedicate to new projects and learning new things. But I did it. I worked and I researched and I learned every single day. And I am still doing that. So if I can do it, you can do it as well. So don't wait for tomorrow, for next week, next month. Start today and you can do it. The last question that I have for this video is, are women good developers? And to be more specific, someone has written in my comments that women cannot be good developers. The answer to this question is no, they are not. I am just an exception.
What the hell?
To be honest, I think that this comment is very rude, but at the same time, I cannot be offended because this is not true. This is just discrimination. And if you are dealing with discrimination of any type, based on your religion, your nationality, your gender, the way you look, your race, you have to understand that this is not your fault. In most cases, this is the other person coming from a place of fear or misunderstanding or from their own insecurities. They are trying to make themselves feel better by putting you down. And what you have to do in this situation is, first of all, you have to look for a person or an organization that can help you. And then, second thing is, don't ever forget who you are. Don't ever forget your core values, and don't let anyone else tell you that you are not good enough. Always focus on your strengths and on your good sides. Always. So with this question, I'm going to end the video, but if you like these types of videos, you can leave me your questions in the comment section and I might make another video like this one in the future. So thank you very much for watching and I will see you in some other video. Bye! I'm so hungry.